Okay, so this is our vlog that we're doing to submit to Growing Up Disabled, edited by Carly Findlay. I'm Melanie Thompson, this is my son Ridley. Say hi, Ridley.
Hi.
Okay, so should we talk about disability?
Yes.
Okay, you keep looking at the camera. Okay, so when I was pregnant with you, I had a test at 12 weeks into the pregnancy that basically was having to measure whether or not you had a thick bit at the back of your neck. It was called a neutral coil hernia, and that was to tell if you had Down syndrome, which is a trisomy genetic disorder. You didn't have it, but when I went in, when I went into the test,
I'm busy filming.
When I went into that test, I remember thinking, well, whatever the outcome of this test is, I'm going to keep the baby. Yeah? So even if you were born at 12 weeks, I'd been told that you might be disabled, I was still going to keep the baby. Thank you, sit up. So that was the first thing. And then you were born, and you seemed fine to me. I'd never known any of that before. And you had a pretty cool childhood when you were in Yorkshire, hey?
Maybe discuss what happened when I was 3.
Okay, let's discuss what happened when you were 3. Talk to the computer. Come closer.
So when I was 3, she got a new job, and we decided to move to Australia, where she used to live.
Yes. And what is that? Explain to the benefit of the camera.
Suffer from autism. I love being lazy.
I don't think autism is a feature of. I don't think laziness is a feature of autism. What does being autistic mean to you? What does it mean? What do you think it means? What does mommy tell you it means? Keep forgetting things? No, well, daddy's got that. I think that's from his acquired brain injury. Mummy gets that, and I think that's from menopause. So I don't think it's good to keep forgetting things. So what else do you think it means? How do you think that you're different from your friends at school?
Giraffe neck!
Giraffe neck. So these are all things that are not related to autism, are they? So how does autism affect you in your daily life? Do you feel autistic? How do you feel different from your friends?
I'm a little taller than most people in my class.
Yep. You are taller than most people in your class.
I'm
what else?
Second tallest.
And how else are you different to them?
I pay less attention.
So you pay less attention in class, okay, let's unpack that a bit. Sit up, talk to the camera. So you pay less attention in class.
Yes.
Okay, is that because you don't like listening?
Yes.
Why, does it make you feel worried to listen?
Yes.
Why? Explain for the vlog.
Most of the people are adults and I'm pretty sure they know what I mean.
No, I don't think so. You need to explain it. It's not clear. Talk to the camera.
Maybe it's like, maybe something going on with the teacher.
Okay, so you're scared the teacher's going to kill you if you don't do it correctly. Look at the camera.
Yes.
Okay, so that's an anxiety that you have. Right, okay. So that's often an attribute of people with autism. They get a little bit anxious. Mummy's now got an anxiety disorder. But she got that from being upset. Too many jobs where she was asked to do things that she didn't were against her values. But anyway, so what else? What else about being autistic? I mean, do you feel disabled? Does it stop you from doing anything you want to do? No? So you don't actually feel disabled at all. It's just you. Yeah? It's just you? to talk to the camera? Had enough? Okay, let's talk about my disability now. When mummy had her optic neuritis and got diagnosed with multiple sclerosis, what did that mean for you and for you? Talk to the camera. What happened to mummy? You don't know?
I can't remember.
It was 4 years ago. But what about more recently? What happened more recently with mummy's health that changed things around at the house? Well, that was 4 years ago, but on top of the holes in my brain, what happened? I lost my job. And that was because, well, no, not really, but I got very, very sick. Remember when I couldn't get off the couch?
Yes.
And I was just like there eating biscuits every day and I wasn't going outside? That was because of depression. And I have post-traumatic stress disorder. So what do you think that means? What's that? Come closer.
Feel sad.
Feel
that's
sad? Like, yeah, you feel sad. So how did that affect, when mummy was sad, how did that affect you and Thea? Thought I was you were an annoyance to me? Was I angry all the time? Were they grumpy? And what about now? Talk to the camera.
No.
What's happening now?
We're at a museum.
We're at a museum.
Own company?
I have my own company, yeah. So that's been an improvement. Do you want to work for my company? What's the job that you want to do when you grow up? What's your dream job?
Work at Nintendo.
Work at Nintendo? As a game developer, yeah? Now we talked about that because Nintendo headquarters is in Japan. So what are you going to have to do to achieve that dream?
Learn Japanese.
Oh,
I won't listen to the Duolingo bird.
Oh, come on. The Duolingo bird's fabulous.
Go tell that to everyone that missed their lessons.
I think you've listened to too many conspiracy theories on YouTube. Just saying. So is there anything else you'd like to add to this video? So you basically don't feel disabled. You don't feel different than everybody else. And you're growing up disabled, but actually you don't feel disabled. So do you think it's just society that labels people with autism as disabled when actually you're just... It's wrong. Okay, explain why it's wrong. That's a good point.
It sometimes limits us.
Okay. So social... The social disabilities, it limits you? How does it limit you?
Sometimes stop you from doing things.
Okay, and we had that, didn't we, last weekend? We went to talk to the drone pilots from the army. And we said, because you had autism, that you weren't allowed to go in the army. And you would have been a good drone pilot in the army, wouldn't you? Yeah, so what do you have to say? What do you have to say to the army?
Viva la revolution.
Viva la revolution. Okay, maybe that's not so good to have to go in the army. But what would you say to these people that don't employ autistic people because they're scared that you're somehow disabled?
Really?
Yeah, really. Maybe you should get over yourselves, Australian Defence Force, and you should have people like Ridley, high-functioning autistic children, in flying your drones because he's really, really good at it. Your skills at that are pretty good. I haven't. I've done pretty well. What are you trying to say?
It's going to be a swear eventually.
No, I'm not going to swear. This is we're doing this for a book. We have to be polite. Yeah. Anything else you'd like to add to the tank? No. Okay, well, I'm glad we've had this chat, really.
And to the viewers.
And thank you to the viewers for listening.